being a priest. That's a soft gig.
Be as cocky once the Baron's men whip your arms.
Geralt of Rivia.
Ha! Sit with us, Witcher.
Found your message on a notice board.
You see, Palmerin, I told you. The griffin at White Orchard. I knew that were we only to follow the tracks of its slayer, we would in the end find Geralt.
Milton de Peyrac Peyrin and Palmerin de Lawnful. Good to see you both. Been years.
Be assured, we share your joy.
You must forgive us our surroundings. When we pledged to place the village under our protection, the village elder gave us this hut as our lodgings. He swore it is the best hut in the village.
Get involved in some squabble?
We discovered that in retreating, the Redanian garrison that left this land still is at the mercy of numerous plagues. A tyranny of bandits, the most onerous among them. These plunderers shall soon descend on this village to collect tribute. Milton and I will dissuade them.
We are both sworn to fight injustice and oppression wherever they rear their heads. The matter does not concern you, of course, but do us the kindness of waiting. Once we have dealt with these marauders, we have a matter we must present to you.
So, plan to go out and meet the bandits when they arrive? Fight them?
Palmerin wishes first to appeal to their sense of decency. But I expect they will be deaf to this.
Yeah, completely.
We must afford them a chance to stand down. Many a hardened outlaw has left the path of wrongdoing upon hearing words of admonition.
Doesn't happen in these lands. Ever.
If they do not heed my reprimand, we at least will know we have done all within our means to evade bloodshed.
Fine. Naturally, I'll help when Palmerin's rhetoric falls on deaf ears.
Excellent. Then we've but to wait for the rogues to arrive.
They are coming!
Hear that? Your bandits have arrived.
Let us go out to greet them.
He mean us?
I, Palmerin de Lawnfall, call upon you to repent. Search your hearts. Do you not see that they are blackened?
Regular punch and duty here.
To prey upon commoners is no honor. To loot their meager stores, abandon the path of shame, and we will spare you.
Right, good jest, that. Had us a laugh. Now, fuck off or we lose our patience and you lose something else.
Nay, wait, Zorg. These lads are a lark. Mayhaps they know some tricks.
Oi, players! Can you toss balls all loopity-like? Or do that thing where one spits fire while the other farts?
Noble Palmerin's given you a chance. Now I'm gonna give you some advice. Do what he says.
Or what?
Or you'll find yourself fighting knights errant in the pay of the Duchess of Toussaint, and they eat scum like you with their morning porridge.
Well, there's three of them. Two turtled up in armor. We'll come back later.
Some wench sent them. Folk who say we's afeard of wenches and jesters.
Ooh, insulted the Duchess. Not good.
Indeed, we cannot let the affront go unpunished. I swear upon the Heron you will pay with your own blood!
By the the crane! Villains, ready your arms!
Why do they not emerge? It is over. We have banished the scoundrels, lifted oppression's yoke from their lives.
Warned you it'd be like this. Fear you as much as they did the bandits now. Sorry, no fanfares and flowers. You're not in Toussaint.
Ach, it is true what folk claim. In the north, no noble deed goes unthwarted. It is time to go home.
And we shall, my friend.
Come, Geralt. It's time we delivered our message.
So fess up. What brings you such a long way?
We are to deliver Her Grace the Duchess's message in full, with all due ceremony. For tradition...
is sacred in Toussaint. All right, fine.
Most honorable Geralt, slayer of monsters and all evils nefarious, which prey on the defenseless of this world.
Whereas never have you been known to deny help to the innocent, nor leave widows and orphans to fates undeserved. Answer you now our present summons.
Free us from the beast which floods our streets with blood, and sows panic in the hearts of rich and poor alike. Come to our aid, Witcher. Thus humbly beseeches you the star-crossed city's most gracious protectress, Her Illustrious Highness, Duchess Anna Henrietta.
Shall you answer her call?
Anna Henrietta really say all that? Word for word?
Well, in point of fact, she said, bring me the Witcher and dare not spare your horses. Only make certain this time he comes alone. The Ducal Chamberlain added the rest. You know how it is.
Yeah, I remember.
I might add, be it unofficially, that a hefty reward awaits. Yet the specifics you will need to verify with Her Illustrious Highness.
Might be the most fervent request that I take a contract ever. And the most polite. And now we've got all that behind us. I want to hear more about this beast. Some kind of monster? Just guessing.
Most assuredly, though no one has caught a good look at it as yet, our only sure witnesses, bodies massacred in a brutal, horrid manner.
Look. Some sketches drafted from descriptions given by those who claim they glimpsed the beast. Each quite different. To my mind, these witnesses lie.
How many victims so far?
Two. When Her Grace learnt of the second, she discharged us immediately to fetch you, promising grants of land and fortunes in gold, should you answer her summons.
An ill wind blows, Geralt. The beast cannot be tracked. Folks say it wields black magic. Also, both victims were nobly born, and the start of a tourney draws near.
beast wields black magic? What makes you say so?
The first victim vanished between bites at a feast. Of the feastgoers, none noticed this. They saw but an open window, then heard desperate cries from the street below, where a corpse had just been found.
The second killing, similar. A knight in a locked room. Servants all about the house. Guards all around the estate. Yet the beast somehow got him out, dragged him to the town square, and killed him there. No one saw nor heard a thing.
We have no fear of creatures against which sword and shield protect, but of this beast, nothing is known. Save that it cannot be traced, kills effortlessly, and with no rhyme or reason we can discern.
Anyone tried to hunt it? Knights errant, for example?
Ha! Many have tried. Baiting, waiting in ambush, but to no avail.
The beast is clever. It evades all traps and attacks of a sudden. It is like a ghost.
An experienced tracker. This is what we need, with knowledge of monsters. In short, we need you.
Mentioned a tourney. Why doesn't the Duchess just call it off?
Simply, it is too late. The guests have arrived. The best knights of all lands, relatives of the Emperor. The beast could be a threat to others, not just to Her Grace's subjects.
Got it. Before an aristocrat dies, at best it's a scandal. At worst, a diplomatic incident. I sometimes think back to all the contracts I've ever taken from sovereigns. Can't name hardly any where I came out ahead.
You cannot be thinking to refuse.
No. Just struck by a thought. How the Duchess can sometimes be... demanding.
So you accept the contract? Excellent!
We must set off at once. We long wanted this land searching for you. Yet time is of the essence.
Ready to go, as soon as you're packed.
Ha! Then post haste to Toussaint.
To Toussaint!
Toussaint, the land of love and wine.
Exactly how I remembered it.
You will find Beauclerc has changed some these past years.
Walk about when you have the chance. You will see for yourself.
To me, place always seemed straight out of a fairy tale. Knights errant, elven palaces.
You insinuate that we are somehow odd? I shall prove you wrong. This I pledge on the Heron.
Yeah.
Big beast. Tackling it single-handed? None too wise.
Neither is love born of wisdom, Witcher. So, Guillaume, out with it. Which fair damsel inspired you to vow to kill that filth?
The most beautiful among them.
If he wishes to guard her name a secret, he need not reveal it.
You I do not know, sir, nor seem you a knight, yet still I am profoundly grateful, nay, indebted to you for your succor. This trophy, sir, is yours.
A giant this close to human settlements? Strange.
Well, that was no ordinary giant. His name was Golyat, rumored to have been a knight once, but one who broke his vows. For this, the Lady of the Lake transformed him into a wild giant and banished him into the Gorgon Hills.
So he came back down? Why?
Several times each year, hunger chased him into the lowlands. Golyat had killed and devoured many shepherds. Guillaume's hunt served a noble cause. At any rate, it's a tale for more agreeable environs.
I'll take the trophy. Why not? Could find someone who'll pay to buy it. Put up a good fight against the giant. Got experience battling monsters?
None. In Toussaint, we mostly chase bandits. But I vowed I'd bring my heart's champion the head of a monstrosity, as the famed Gottfried, known as the Giant Killer, did.
You don't mean to hunt the beast, I hope. The matter's best left to Geralt.
Another challenge awaits me. Yet if Geralt is to hunt the beast, he ought to know. It struck again.
The river surrendered a corpse. It washed up in the meander by the cockatrice. Damien Delatour's guardsmen are there already, securing the area.
Securing the area? Better go there now before they trample any tracks, manhandle any evidence.
Set forth, then. I shall ride for the city to inform her gracious magnificence that Geralt has arrived. We'll meet later, near Guillaume's tent at the Tourney grounds. I shall take you then to see her grace.
Brave kid, Guillaume.
Palmerin oversaw his upbringing. Guillaume is his kin.
Get used to the way you knights talk, especially how you switch back and forth between flowery and, well, abnormal.
A knight's errand, in the service of her gracious magnificence. When we appear in her name or speak on her behalf, we are bound by tradition. No one here. They must have removed the body already.
Let's look around, make sure they didn't miss anything. Hobnailed boots, multiple sets of prints. Ducal guard, clearly. Let's see where they went. Walked along the shoreline.
Perhaps the body lay on the bank.
Anything taken by the current ends up in these shallows.
Yes, the stench is fierce.
Got guests. Careful.
I will tell you all!
Okay.
By the smell of blood. Let's keep looking. Only blood-soaked scraps left of the victim's clothing. Good quality cloth.
A wealthy victim, correct?
Looks it. Footprints. See them? And a rut made by the hull of a boat. Left recently, I'd say. Only blood-soaked scraps left of the victim's clothing. Good quality cloth.
A wealthy victim, correct?
Looks it. Dragged some nets onto the bank, then cut them to untangle them. Lot of blood, so the corpse must have been cut up. Quartered, maybe.
It's likely they loaded the body parts onto a boat and sailed off.
DLC. A noble's accessory, clearly.
What now?
This isn't the site of the murder. We know that. Current brought the body here. Corpse got caught in the nets. Guardsmen pulled it out, put it in a boat and took it somewhere. Need to find out where. I'd like to look at the corpse before it starts to decompose.
The inn. Its patrons must have seen the guardsmen, which direction they took. We should ask there.
Seems we've got ourselves an audience.
You think this surprising? The locals will tell the children of children they do not have yet of the day a quartered corpse was pulled from the river.
One thing. Found a handkerchief in the water. Monogrammed DLC. Mean anything to you?
Delacroix? It cannot be. Was it he the beast slew?
Seems so. Knew him well?
Long past. We were close friends once, but our paths diverged. He was a man of extremes. Standing by his companions, no matter the odds. Fighting his foes to the bitter end.
Foes? You have a lot of them?
He did. But I do not see what that has to do with the beast. Ah, Geralt. You've struck a raw nerve. Memories of a time long past, to which I'd rather not return now.
I understand. We can talk later. Let's go to the tavern.
I shall have to leave you soon. Return to court.
I got back to Toussaint.
A knight in the service of Her Illustrious Highness knows no rest. In fact, I'd feared I would return too late to fulfill my duty. Yet it seems I've arrived in the nick of time. Once you have finished examining the corpse, be sure to report to Anarieta.
Anarieta?
Her Grace, the Duchess. I forget myself at times. We address each other by our first names in private. Never in Pomeroy's presence, however. He finds such familiarity offensive. Ooh. A watering hole for traders, smugglers, boatmen.
But you will find no better crayfish chowder in all Toussaint.
Killer from the north, they say. What? With no lads brave enough?
Of course we have, but bravery is not enough against the beast.
By my troth, could that be the musty scent of fresh pate?
Naught else, Sir de Peyrac Peyron. I see time has not dulled your senses.
We would be honored if you would join us. Your companion as well.
But why do I not detect even a whiff of crayfish chowder?
No soup today, on account of there being no crayfish. I reckon you've not heard, but all I caught was a corpse. I awoke at the crack of dawn, as I do each day, but when I looked up, I beheld a blood-red sky.
This corpse is precisely why we're here. For the man whom you've invited to join you at the table was summoned from a far-off land by her gracious magnificence. He is tasked with tracking and killing the beast.
We invited two men to join us, yet since Sir de Peyrac Peyron in temperament is more akin to hare than hound, I surmise the other is the hunter. With whom do we have the pleasure?
Name's Geralt.
A humble introduction. You've clearly not tarried long with Sir de Peyrac Peyron.
Spare us the petty insults. Geralt is a master of the witchering trade. He has questions concerning the beast's last victim.
I was the one to find the corpse. The sun had just risen when I awoke, sat straight up in my bed, looked out the window, and beheld a sky red as blood.
Ask him, please, or we shall be here till winter.
Must have been early in the morning. Went to check your nets and then...
I stepped out of my hut and saw...
By my troth, to the point, man. You found a body ensnared in your crayfish nets. We know this already. What happened then? Did you see anyone nearby? Did you spy anything noteworthy? Anything at all?
Not a soul around, just me. As for noteworthy... Well...
What did you see? But be warned, if I hear the sky was red again...
I saw... a head. Bobbing, eyes bulging, the tongue blew and popped out. Next to it, a hand rocking upon the water.
Get a good look at the body parts?
They gave me such a fright, I bolted to town fast as my legs would take me, then returned with guardsmen who told me to keep out of their way. They had a hard haul. The parts were so tangled up in my nets, they were forced to cut them.
Need to examine the body. Know where they took it?
They ferried it across, then loaded it on a cart and hauled it to a cellar at Corfo Bianco to keep it cool, see?
What? Why, Corfo Bianco is Baron Rossell's estate. When he learns they've turned his cellar into a morgue, he'll set his hounds on them.
While you were gallivanting about the north, his vineyard was auctioned off.
Who was that? Woman who just left? Didn't see her before. Didn't notice her walk in, either.
Doubtless Linus, the innkeep's daughter. But hold, Geralt, because this is an outrage. Rossell's vineyard was auctioned off? Inconceivable!
It is no secret the Baron had gambling debts up to his ears. It finally came time to collect. His creditors auctioned off his property. The Ducal Chancellery bought it, in fact. Rossell now bunks with his brother in Vicar Farr.
I told Rossell he'd get his comeuppance. How long can one draw on past heroics? His creditors must finally have defined that his promises meant nothing.
Such are the times. Today's knights are pale shadows of the heroes of yore.
It's true what they say. God sent the beast to punish us for straying from the old paths.
So folk think the beast's divine punishment.
Knights have turned their backs on the old customs. Where they were defenders of the duchy, they're now defenders of their own tushes.
Why, you insolent!
Let him talk.
The Duchess trades in titles, grants honors to ill-doers. We've strayed from the path of virtue, lost the gods' favor, so the gods sent retribution.
Don't listen to that nonsense, Geralt. It's rehashed street preacher Codsworth.
Yes, the rebel rousers have been sprouting up like weeds lately, each offering the same bill of goods.
They say anything else about the beast, besides it being a messenger of the gods?
The Toussaintois are no fools. They see clearly the beast kills on days honoring patron saints.
Picky monster. Thanks for the hospitality. Time I examined the corpse.
Corvo Bianco lies a short way from here, near the tourney grounds. Just follow the road and you'll arrive.
Not coming with? Oh yeah. Duty of some sort calls.
Some sort? Her Grace bestowed a great honor on me, even before we departed for Velen. I'm to play the hare during this year's game in the palace gardens. When you see me in my costume, you will wet yourself laughing.
A little tempted to ask a few questions, but it sounds like a long, complicated story. One involving lengthy digressions into local history and tradition. So, see you later, Milton, and good luck.
Where's the fire?
Sounds of a fight. Have to hurry. Damn it. Kelly must still be here. Took a solid hit. Woman from the inn was wearing this coat. In the cellar, gotta be. Claw wounds from 5 separate claws, spread of a small human hand, massacred by a vampire. Not Nekimara, though. Or Fletter, Bruxa, gotta be. Footprints. Small, bare feet. Lead deeper into the cellar. Hurled against the wall with great force. Took a lot of strength to batter this down. Used this to batter down the grate. You. Saw you at the inn. I know what you are. Don't know why you killed these people, though. Clearly wasn't for their blood. Don't have to fight.
You are wrong. I cannot let you leave.
Down.
Waterlogged, both hands amputated. Body was quartered, just as I thought. Laid in water for some time. Head swollen, and something took a few bites out of it. Something in the throat. A pouch, bulging with coins. Elfguardian florins, from several different provinces. If the murderer did this, means we're dealing with a sentient, thinking beast. Body was chopped up after death. Blows struck with great force, but bones sliced through, not crushed. Creature that killed him had long claws, sharp as a witcher's blade. First sank its claws into the victim's heart. No Bruxa did this. Third hand. A spare? Except it's clearly not the victim's. Guardsmen must have not noticed it as they picked everything up. How's this possible? Still warm. Blood still flowing. Several monster species can regenerate. Never heard of that happening to their severed limbs, though. Or of their limbs seeming completely alive after so much time. Examine the tissue more closely later. Might learn something. So, murderer was clearly a monster, but not a Bruxa. But then why'd the Bruxa come here for the severed hand? And who does the hand belong to? Why the hell's it still warm? Now, pouch shoved down the victim's throat. What's the significance? And why was he chopped up into pieces? Lots of questions, no answers so far. Need to know about the other victims. I'll ask Palmerin to get me in to see the Duchess.